Good morning. Welcome to WJZ.com. The Harbor Shuttle, right on time at 7 o'clock, going from, you set your watch to this, going from the Rusty Scupper over to Harbor East. It is starting to get windy. You can see the motion of this northwest wind on the waters of the inner and the outer harbor. What we're looking at here is the back end of precip that was with us during the overnight. I'm making this presentation for you at 7:02. I'm going to give you another update in a couple of hours as we have watched this. Frankly, it was a slug of rain all night long, a mild, gentle rain. We've been watching this pass very quickly across the state. Winds have now shifted from what they were at about 5 o'clock here in Baltimore out of the west-southwest to strong out of the northwest, and that means blustery cold conditions as we move through the day. Let me show you something cool that's going on right now, though. And again, it's been all green across the state during the overnight. But then all of a sudden, this moisture and cold air hits the Chesapeake Bay, and we're getting a little bay effect. We always talk about lake effect, which you can see up here, colder air blowing over the warmer Great Lakes. Well, now we're getting some bay effect. It's momentary. It's not a real issue, but it is a cool phenomenon and something pretty interesting to look at on radar. You give it an hour, hour and a half, and all this moisture will clear the state. And then it's temperatures that we've got to talk about. I don't want to show them to you. Let's go out to Tawnytown now, where it's 27. Heck, it was in the mid-30s at 5 o'clock. We were at 38. We're now down 34 degrees. Currently, Oakland has a wind chill of minus 4 degrees. Wind chill here is 25. This high means business. Clear, cold today and tonight. Tomorrow will moderate a little bit, but then we're going to see a warm-up out ahead of our next moisture on Sunday, and that should give us just a rain event. But we're going to play it safe and say rain may be mixing with a little bit of wet snow as we move through Sunday afternoon and then into Sunday night. The question is, Monday morning, will there be any moisture around? Is yet another area of high pressure comes in, dragging some chilly air with it. But the real cold air that could be our life in early February, it's just not going to be present. Here's that cold air projection graphic that I love to use. Here we are, Friday morning by 9 a.m. Look at what's coming our way. Temperatures falling down to a low of 12 tonight. Then they lift tomorrow, make a brief return on Sunday and Monday morning, lifts right back up again. And that's a good thing because we know midweek there's going to be another impulse move our way from the eastern face of the Rockies. And right now it's going to be too warm for anything but rain midweek. So temperatures fall as we move through this day. It is becoming sunny as we speak. 12 will be your overnight low. This is before wind chill. Tomorrow, the blustery winds will still be a breeze, 33 and 12. Then look, here's this warm-up on Sunday. And then Monday, 39. Tuesday, 40. 45 degrees on Wednesday. Wednesday, 45 and 36 again. We don't get anywhere near freezing, so just a rain event on midweek. It's Groundhog Day, folks. The second day of February, 2018. TGIF, everybody. Ain't it the truth? Thanks so much for stopping by. WJZ.com.